Welcome you all to Success Mantra.
I hope everyone would have seen the previous video on airstream mechanism. If you haven't watched it yet, I'll link it above. Please do have a look at it. Now we are going to look at the phonation process. So without any further delay, let's move on to the video.
The movement of the vocal cords inside the larynx during the production of the sound is called as the phonation process. When the glottis is wide open, voiceless sounds are produced, whereas when the glottis is loosely held, voiced sounds are produced due to the vibrations of the glottis. So now, what is voiced sounds and voiceless sounds? Voiced sounds are those sounds when you make your throat to vibrate. Voiceless sounds are those sounds when your throat does not vibrate. Here, I have given the voiced and voiceless consonants. Voiced. If you look at the words vat. Now, just look at the letter V. When you pronounce the letter V, your throat vibrates. You can just touch your throat and feel it. Similarly, pronounce the word gum. Gum. You can feel that your throat is vibrating. When you pronounce any word, if your throat vibrates, it is called as voiced sounds. Similarly, the word bit, zip, done,
gin,
this, pleasure. And now look at the unvoiced, that is no vibration. There is no vibration felt in your throat. Just pronounce the word fat. Fat. You'll not feel any vibrations in your throat. Similarly, see all the words which are in blue. Come. Come. Pit. Sip. Chin. Chin. Thick. Pressure. You can feel the difference in the last word very clearly. Pleasure and pressure. Voiceless sounds, the air stream moves out without vibrating when the glottis is wide open, producing voiceless sounds. Similarly, voiced sounds, an air stream moves out with vibrations. That is, when the glottis is loosely held, it causes the vocal cords to open and close rapidly. One note, this is important for one mark questions. All the vowels are voiced sounds. Here I have given the consonants differentiating voiced and unvoiced, but the vowels are always voiced sounds in the English language. Now we are in the third topic, the articulatory process. First, we looked at the airstream mechanism. Second, the phonation process. And now we are in the articulatory process. The things we'll discuss under the articulatory process are the speech organs. The speech organs are called as the articulators. Under that, we'll look at the active articulators and passive articulators. Velic closure and velar closure, oral sounds and nasal sounds, and nasalized sounds. We have already looked at the definitions, but we'll more deeply look at these topics once again. These topics are very brief for 2 marks, especially. Under the articulatory process, we'll first discuss speech organs. The organs which are involved in the production of speech sounds are called as speech organs. The trachea, the larynx, the glottis, the pharynx, the tongue, the lips, the upper teeth, alveolar ridge, hard palate, soft palate, also called as the velum, and uvula. These are the organs which are involved in the production of speech. Let's look where are these organs present in the human body. The trachea. The trachea is also called as the windpipe. It connects the larynx to the lungs, allowing the passage of air. The next is larynx. Larynx
is called as the voice box.
The highlighted part is called as the larynx. It is an organ at the top of the neck which is involved in breathing, production of speech sounds, and protecting the trachea against food aspirations. And the third one is pharynx. The pink color part is called as the pharynx. It is a membrane lined cavity present behind the nose and the mouth. It connects the larynx and esophagus, that is the food pipe. The next one is tongue. The lips. The movement of lips also is a reason for the production of speech sounds. And also the upper teeth. Now comes the alveolar ridge. The alveolar ridge is present either on the roof of the mouth, between the upper teeth and the hard palate, or on the bottom of the mouth behind the lower teeth as shown in this image. Hard palate. What does the word palate means? The roof of the mouth is called as the palate. The hard palate is nothing but the front part of the roof of the mouth. Next, we look at the soft palate. Soft palate is also called as velum. It is nothing but the back part of the roof of the mouth. The front part is called as the hard palate, whereas the back part is called as the soft palate. Next, we'll discuss about uvula. Uvula is nothing but a fleshy extension at the back of the soft palate which hangs above the throat. Here you can see in this image. Now, as we have looked at all the articulatory organs, we'll go on with the active articulators and passive articulators. So, what are active articulators? Active articulators are those organs which can move. For example, the lower jaw, the tongue, and the soft palate. Similarly, what are passive articulators? The articulators which cannot move during the production of speech sounds are called as passive articulators. Here, the examples are the upper jaw, the alveolar ridge, and the hard palate. Moving on to velic closure and velar closure. So, what is velic closure? The velic closure prevents the airflow into the nasal cavity. The velic closure happens when the velum shuts the nasal passage completely as shown in this figure. Whereas, what is velar closure? Velar closure is the closure formed by the back of the tongue containing the underside of the soft palate. That is, the velar closure takes place when the back of the tongue is raised as shown in this image. Moving on to oral sounds and nasal sounds. Here I have given the definitions of oral sounds. This you can write it in your examinations. But generally, what is an oral sound? Oral sound is the sound which is produced from your mouth. That is, when the air from your lungs comes out through your mouth and the sound is produced from your mouth, it is called as the oral sounds. Similarly, nasal sounds. When the air from your lungs comes out through the nasal passage, that is your nose, it is called as the nasal sounds, as shown in this image. In the first image, you could see that the arrow marks depicts the flow of air from your lungs.
The arrow marks flow through your mouth.
But in the nasal sounds, the arrow mark comes out through your nasal passage. Next, we look at the nasalized sounds. So, what are these nasalized sounds? Nasalized sounds are those sounds where the air from the lungs moves out both through the oral cavity as well as the nasal cavity. This image clearly depicts the nasalized sound. That is, the air from the lungs moves through the oral cavity as well as the nasal cavity. And here I have given a note. The speech sounds are described by the nature of astream, the state of the glottis, the position of the soft palate, the active and passive articulators. Further, we have to describe the speech sounds, that is, the way in which the speech sounds are produced. In the examination, we'll be asked to describe a speech sound. For that, we need to know the nature of astream mechanism, whether it is the pulmonic astream mechanism or glottalic astream mechanism or the velaric astream mechanism. The second one which we have to describe is the state of glottis. The state or the position of glottis. The third is that the position of the soft palate. Whether the soft palate is raised or lowered. And the fourth one is the type of articulators used in the production of speech sound, whether it is active articulator or passive articulators. These eight subtopics under the articulatory process are very brief, and these are asked only in the 2-mark questions, but these are very main topics to understand the depth of phonetics.
That's all for today, guys. In the next video, we'll discuss about the vowels and consonants and their phonetic symbols, and also the pronunciations. Further, if you have any questions, please do mention it in the comment box. And if you felt this video useful, please do like, share, and subscribe.